Welcome back to my channel. Today I want to take a look at my favorite animal within Celtic mythology. Let's talk about the fox. First of all, you might or might not have noticed my channel logo by now. The logo consists of three parts, and each of those parts has a meaning. Well, at least for me, but maybe you can figure them out. One of those parts is the head, and the head is a depiction of a fox. And why do I choose the fox? Well, for once it's my favorite animal, but also because of the attributes connected to the fox. Of course, every country has their own attributes connected to special animals, but the fox often has very similar attributes in several cultures. For the Celts, the fox was seen as wise and cunning, a trickster, and a strategic and fast thinker, who is highly adaptable to new situations. For the Celts, the fox knew the forest like no other, and was often seen as a wise spirit guide, and a symbol of adjustment to new situations. To see a fox often meant the need to observe others and to observe one's surroundings, while remaining oneself. Similar to the Japanese kitsune, foxes were sometimes believed to be able to shapeshift into humans, if needed, and to seduce humans. But in contrast to their Japanese counterparts, the Celtic foxes are not known to have magical powers, apart from shapeshifting. A famous story about a fox in Irish folklore is the legend of St. Brigid's fox. The legend tells of a king who tamed a wild fox, trained it to do all sorts of tricks, and all in all, dearly loved his pet fox. But since the fox is a wild animal, it was allowed to roam free through the forest near the castle. And so, one day, a man went out to hunt and shot the fox, not knowing that this wasn't indeed a wild fox, but the favorite pet of the king. And when the king heard of the fate of his beloved pet, he grew furious and ordered the men to be arrested and sentenced them to death. The family of the man was desperate and went to St. Brigid to search for help. St. Brigid was known as a lover of animals, but even she thought that a mistake like that doesn't deserve to be punished by death. And so she made her way to the king's court by carriage. On the way, she came across a fox, seeking shelter from hunters, and she had an idea. She ordered her carriage to stop and allow the fox to mount the carriage. The fox was deeply fascinated by St. Brigid and followed her willingly to the king. At court, Brigid still found the king angry about the loss of his pet, and she offered her new companion to be an adequate replacement. But the king refused at first. He told her of the tricks his old pet was able to perform. And St. Brigid? She asked her fox to do the same. And the fox, eager to please Brigid, performed all tricks she asked for, until the king was sure that this fox was indeed an adequate replacement for his pet. He released the arrested man, and Brigid left, knowing that she had reached her goal. But when Brigid left, the palace became a cage for the fox, and without Brigid, he grew sad. And so, after a while, the fox waited for a chance when the king left the castle, to escape and to return into the wilderness, never to be seen again. In the end, foxes can adapt, but they belong to the forests. By the way, the Irish word for fox is Shenach. It can also be Matra Rua, which literally means red dog, but commonly it's Shenach. So it might be plausible that the English term Shenanigans derived from the Irish expression Shenachigan, I play the fox. But that's it for today. A trickster, a survival expert, and a wise spirit. Let me know in the comments down below what attributes you connect to the fox, and what's your favorite animal, and why. See you next time. Bye!